Live from the Councilor's Studios in Nassau, Bahamas, this is Bahamas at Sunrise. And now your hosts, Romuald Ferreira and Anastasia Palacios.
Good morning, Bahamas. Welcome to Bahamas at Sunrise on a marvelous Monday. My name is Romy Ferreira.
And I'm Anastasia Palacios.
And it's a fantastic day. We hope you had a wonderful weekend. And if you're watching Bahamas at Sunrise, of course, we're very appreciative that you made us a part of your morning routine, as you have been doing for the past 14 plus years. And we appreciate it. Take our word for it.
We certainly do. And before we go any further, we must stop our talking right now.
Hold the presses.
A very, very happy, happy birthday to both Fred and Justin Aubrey. That is coming in from your wife and mother, Miss June Aubrey, and the entire staff and crew here at the Councilors. Happy, happy birthday to you both.
All right. And what an excellent week it was for football, for all you football fans out there. Great week. Great game. Last night.
Hey, what happened with the Patriots in the end? I had to go. You know, we had the show this morning. So what happened with the Patriots in the end, Romy?
They finally got their just desserts.
Oh, know? Yeah. Sounds like a plan to me. So I know it's going to be a good week.
It's going to be an excellent week. But we have an excellent show lined up for you. As you may or may not be aware, World AIDS Day is on the horizon. So we're going to find out more information about getting to zero, which is something that is totally achievable for our country.
Yeah, looking forward to that conversation. Well, maybe we've certainly come a long way since the time that we started working with HIV/AIDS patients.
I think so.
And so that's going to be a great conversation. We've also got two segments this morning. That's right, two segments talking about new technology and the way it can transform your business. You're going to want to stay tuned to find out how we're making the process to do business in the Bahamas easier, as well as what are the mobile devices that you can use to start to bring in those big business bucks.
Sure, and I'm going to tell you something right now. That's a big part of Bahamas at Sunrise, trying to make you more aware of what's going on out there, not just in the business community, but in the wider community as well, because we are our brother's keeper. And of course, here, we do care about you. You're a part of our family. But before we get any further, we're going to give you your first look at weather with the one and only Godfrey Burnside.
Weather at Sunrise, brought to you by Bahamas First. First in insurance, today, tomorrow.
Thank you, Romy, and good morning, Bahamas. Your first look at weather sunrise. Your surface shows high pressure to the north of the islands until those winds are starting to decrease. But to the south of the islands, we have a whole lot of clouds because of a trough that's creating showers and thunderstorms, particularly over the central and southeastern islands, and that will continue over the next several days. In your satellite, you can actually see very little clouds in northwest Bahamas, a whole lot of clouds over the central and southeastern islands, and they're producing those showers and thunderstorms. Any weather today, you'll have a mix of sun and clouds, the sun over the northwest, and the cloudiness over the central and southeast Bahamas with some showers and possible thunderstorms. High temperature reaching 83 degrees Fahrenheit. Tonight, we're looking at a few clouds in the northwest Bahamas, partly cloudy to cloudy over the central and southeast Bahamas with those showers and possible thunderstorms. Your low temperature going down to 72 degrees Fahrenheit. And some regional highs and lows across the Caribbean, Barbados 86 and 78. In Jamaica, 84 and 73. Trinidad, 87 and 76. And the Turks and Caicos Islands, 85 and 76. Across North America, Atlanta 64 and 51, in Raleigh 16 and 47, in Miami 82 and 74, Dallas, Texas 57 and 41, and Toronto, Canada 36 and 34. And if you have the weather look, those clouds continue over the central and southeast Bahamas to Wednesday with some clearance where that system moves out. But for the most part, we're looking at partly sunny skies over the northwest Bahamas, include Grand Bahama and New Providence. The temperature daytime will be in the low 80s, at nighttime in the lower 70s. Next cold front, Friday of this week, with increasing cloudiness and some showers. That puts a wrap on your first look at weather sunrise. I'm Godfrey Burnside. Back to you, Romy.
Thanks, Godfrey. Held for the first time in 1988, World AIDS Day hopes to bring awareness to the disease, particularly how it can be prevented, how it could be managed, and more importantly, how can we get to zero, which is achievable. And so this morning we are so very pleased to have Lynette DeVoe. She's the coordinator of research projects at the HIV Center, and we're joined also by Dr. Norad Morgan, who's a public health officer, a medical doctor, and charged with the care for those that are infected. So to both of you, Welcome.
Thank you.
Bahamas at Sunrise. Well, Lynette, ladies first. I'm sure Doc doesn't mind. But let's talk a little bit about World AIDS Day. I mean, why do we need it? What was the sort of genesis that gave birth to this concept that we would have a World AIDS Day?
Well, certainly to bring greater awareness of HIV and AIDS, certainly to garner support for persons affected and affected by HIV. And, you know, oftentimes when we are out doing our presentations, we find persons who say, oh, HIV again. And so they seem to be almost saturated with the whole concept of HIV. But we recognize that HIV is still here. We have over 300 new HIV cases, and that's been a kind of a theme or a trend for some times. And that indicates to us that we have to continuously get the message out that persons must be responsible with regards to their sexual health.
When you say new cases, what are you referring to? For this year, 300 new persons?
Well, we're looking at 2013, our most recent stats. And so they show us having over 300 new HIV cases for that particular year.
The issue is that people get fatigued with the message. You kind of get like message fatigued, you know, you're getting bombarded with it, if you understand what I mean.
And so what we have been doing, particularly with regards to prevention education, is looking for creative ways to get the message out there. We recognize that persons are sexually active. We accept that, but we want persons to be responsible with those activities. And so our whole purpose for research is to understand what are some of the barriers, what are some of the factors that impact people making good sexual choices.
Can you tell us? I mean, what are some of the factors?
Well, our promotion is that if you are sexually active, you must use a condom correctly with every single sexual encounter. And so our goal is to understand what are some of the reasons why people choose not to use a condom. And often that we get to think.
But the heat of the moment.
Well, you know, but there's a trust, you know, because we're doing an assessment.
Ah.
And so one of the questions that we ask persons is, what are some of the reasons why you would not use a condom or didn't use a condom? And they're not available, issue of, well, I trust my partner, I don't like the feel. So those are some of the comments that we get. And so the goal right now as we move forward, moving towards zero, is to address some of those issues.
Well, Dr. Morgan, yes. Many a partner has been infected by partners that they trust, love, etc.
Yes.
And that cuts both sides,
yes.
Male to female, female to male.
Yes.
Well, let's talk a little bit about the care,
yes,
of persons with HIV, because obviously it's like anything else in our community, it demands a response.
Yes.
And so what has been our response?
Well, our response is that HIV patients, my role is I'm a medical officer in the Department of Public Health, and I see patients at the HIV centers on 4 days a week. It's a newly formed ambulatory care facility, if you will, and it involves counseling patients who are newly infected and initiating their therapy, should they require therapy, and follow up. I also act as a liaison with the hospital in terms of not only seeing newly infected patients, but I see defaulters, patients who have fallen away from care, from clinic appointments, from the HIV medications. And so should they require hospital admission at the Princess Margaret Hospital, I act as an intermediary between the HIV AIDS Center at Royal Victoria Gardens and Princess Margaret Hospital.
Now, the United Nations has a campaign, Fast Track to Zero.
Yes.
Let's talk a little bit about that.
Well, we want HIV stats to go to zero. That's what we desire. However, in the interim, we want patients to be ready for a cure, should that come about. So we encourage patients to take their antiretroviral medications in wait for a cure. And so we want them to be consistent with that, because we notice that if patients take their antiretroviral medications and they're HIV infected, of course, they don't get the opportunistic infections, those infections that are associated with HIV, and mortality is significantly reduced. And time has proven that patients who are compliant with their HIV medications live a long, healthy life, and they wouldn't fall prey to all the infections that cause death in HIV infection and cause them to progress from HIV to AIDS.
What are some of the barriers? I mean, to our understanding here at Bahamas at Sunrise, HIV medication is provided free of charge.
It is provided free of charge.
What,
yes,
then would be some of the barriers to Well, if you overcome the cost factor, you know, which is a huge impediment to health.
And like many chronic medical illnesses, diabetes and hypertension patients tend not to be compliant. For some patients may complain about side effects of the medication. Some patients may just not want to be bothered. More recently, I'm garnering that a lot of patients, when they take their medications, they tend to kind of face reality that I am infected and I'm in the long haul with this medication. A lot of patients just give up on their medications. And, you know, a lot of the reasons are not clear because, you know, as physicians and as healthcare providers in the HIV/AIDS, we sometimes wonder why patients wouldn't do this. It's free. It's been proven to prevent them from progressing from HIV/AIDS to AIDS. It's not clear, but a lot of patients complain about, I have to take this all the time. I'm so tired of taking it. Mm-hmm. But, and that is where education and continual counseling comes in, where we have to tell them all the time, you have to take your medication. It has been proven, not only anecdotally, but scientifically, that if you take your medication, you'll be fine.
So this is why we need continued research, I guess, and attitudes, et cetera. First of December, though, is a big day. It's an earmark day, and it's coming up.
Yes, tomorrow. Just like to add that you know, we still have a major issue with regards to stigma and discrimination. Yes.
Sure.
And a lot of persons, unlike many of the chronic illness, where a person, you know, they have no problem saying, you know, I have high blood pressure. We have not attained that status.
It's a socially accepted chronic disease, high blood pressure and diabetes. When you start talking about HIV, though,
we still have the stigma.
It's a lot of fear.
Exactly. And we find that that's a huge barrier. We have progressed significantly when we look at the overall response to HIV some 20 plus years ago to where we are now. But there's still a major challenge with regards to people feeling the fear, or perceived stigma. You know, so those are some of the issues in addition to, you know, the challenges with the medication that we find.
All right. Well, thank you so much for being on Bahamas at Sunrise. We know tomorrow, 1st of December, is Red Ribbon Day.
Yes.
So you're encouraging persons to wear the red ribbon and bring further awareness.
Absolutely. And we will be at St. Matthew's Anglican Church on Church Street. We will be celebrating. Every year we have our annual church service at 1 o'clock. So anyone in the area, we invite them to come out and join us. As a matter of fact, tonight we will be at Fort Charlotte, where we will have our candlelight vigil to recognize those persons who are living with HIV and to honor and remember those who have passed.
All right. Well, Lynette DeVoe and Dr. Morgan, thank you so much for being on Bahamas at Sunrise. Congratulations.
Thank you.
For all the work you do in our community, and keep up the good work.
Thank you.
You're watching Bahamas at Sunrise. We'll be back after this.
Good afternoon. First Response, how can I help you?
I've been in an accident on West Bay Street. Can you send someone to help?
Yes, ma'am. A first response team will be there in 15 minutes. Are you hurt?
No, I'm fine, but a bit upset.
We're glad you're not hurt. Please, try to relax. Our team will take care of everything as soon as they arrive.
First Response provides immediate on-site service and support from the scene of an accident through the claims and repair process. And it's free to all Bahamas First insured drivers in New Providence every day for any type of accident. If you drive and want First Response on your side, call 32FIRST or visit BahamasFirst.com for the name of an authorized Bahamas First agent. First Response can't prevent an accident from happening,
but it can certainly ease your mind when it happens.
Need a business license? Simply apply and pay online with the user-friendly online tax administration system, OTAS. VAT registrations, payments, information, forms, confirmation of applications or payments, all online. Even the business license will be emailed directly to successful applicants. So why waste time? With OTAS, our doors are always open. Access OTAS, the online tax administration system, at vat.revenue.gov.bs or email us at taxinquiries@bahamas.gov.bs or call 242-225-7280.
At Henry F. Store Electric Company, we supply all your electric needs for any size project, from residential housing to luxury hotels. We can help you achieve just the right look, from doorbells to chandeliers, table lamps to ceiling fans, wire, conduit, panels, dimmers, switches, plugs, and even tools. And don't forget light bulbs. We have those hard-to-find energy-saving fluorescent bulbs and more. Henry F. Store Electric, number 135 Mackey Street. Over 50 years of reliability, service, and low, low prices. We also ship to the Family Islands.
Welcome back to Bahamas at Sunrise. The Attorney General has stated more than once that she remains committed to ensuring that businesses have a smooth process of engaging business in our country. This morning to talk about some of the new initiatives that will allow us to use technology to ease the flow of doing business. I'm saying it and I'm getting excited just thinking about it. We have three outstanding women, two of whom we know very well. We've got our Acting Registrar General, Ms. Deidre Clark, along with Aaliyah Allen. She's the outgoing chairperson and CEO for the Bahamas Financial Services Board, and the incoming CEO for the Financial Services Board, Ms. Tanya McCartney. Good morning and welcome to Bahamas at Sunrise.
Good morning.
So I want to start with you, Ms. Clark Maycock. I want to find out this word, Companies E-Service. It's an initiative that you all have just started, and I want you to find out what it's all about.
Well, thank you very much for the question. The Companies E-Service Initiative is a online service that we have put in place to ensure that persons, the agents, those in the community who use our services, when they want to incorporate a company, whether it's a regular company or an IBC, they can do so online.
Okay.
From beginning to end. Okay. There's no human intervention, so there's they get timely services where they can have these companies incorporated within 24 hours, or even if they want to come into the system and incorporate a company within, what they can have expedited services where they can have the company incorporated right away.
Okay.
In addition to just incorporating the companies, they would be able to file annual returns. They are able to request certificates of good standings, as well as pay annual fees online, and at the end of the day also request certified documents from whatever documents we may have in our records.
All right, so this sounds exciting.
It is.
And I know for business people, they must greatly appreciate it. But I also know that there are a lot of female entrepreneurs that I've been meeting recently, and for most of them, they're only at that let's just get a business license phase. So if people who are interested in incorporating, how long would these services have taken before this time? And why is it now beneficial to be doing this e-process?
I won't say a time.
Okay.
But it was, it has been said to have been very challenging for a lot of agents out there.
Okay.
But with the new initiative, we guarantee you that you will have your documents within a, within the 24-hour period.
That's awesome.
So and the industry so far has indicated that it, this is welcomed. So we're looking forward to launching this, and it will be, by the grace of God, launched the within the first quarter of 2016.
Awesome.
So look forward to it.
I definitely will. Now I want to find out from two of my business ladies sitting in the room. They have had lots of experiences dealing with businesses, particularly with financial services. And for both of you, as people who would have tested the system prior to its launch, why is this something that we need right now?
I think it's about delivering on the promise that we make to not only to our clients, but the promise that the government and other agencies make to businesses in the Bahamas. And we always say that we're striving to be the best little financial center in the world, the most efficient. And this e-service allows us to really deliver on that promise. So, you know, from my perspective and from the board's perspective, it is a welcome initiative. It's something that we're very excited about because we know it's really going to make an appreciable difference in the experience that our clients have with the Bahamas internationally and also for domestic businesses.
Okay.
You know, your everyday, you know, processes are going to be much rendered much more quickly.
All right.
At the end of the day, as well, I'll just add to Aaliyah, it's really about competitiveness as a jurisdiction. We want to be able to and to continue to compete with other international financial centers. And this will help to reposition us and strengthen us as a brand out there when it comes to financial services.
Okay.
It's about ease of doing business and competitiveness.
Okay. So those all sound like very good words, but these ladies are obviously from the financial services section. Will this only apply to financial service institutions, or it's open to all incorporated businesses?
The e-service is open to, first of all, there are two aspects of the e-service. There will be the international business as well as regular incorporations will be affected.
Okay.
The IBCs, only persons who are financial service, corporate service provider mm-hmm. will be able to access the IBC sector of part of the e-service.
Okay.
Regular companies, anybody would be able to access the system to incorporate their regular companies.
Okay. All right, so that's good. Mm-hmm. So our financial services gets that much needed push for the things that it needs
yes.
to grow and develop as yes. our second mm-hmm. Leading industry. And then all of the regular businesses get the opportunity to do the same thing right. as they need it.
As they need
okay, it. Okay, that's good stuff, man. Mm-hmm. So now how do people get, I know you say you launch next year, but what are some of the steps that people need to take now to make sure that they're ready for when you do launch?
Excellent question, and I'm happy you asked that one. We, coming through the, in order for the e-service to be accessed, mm-hmm. there is, persons will have to access it through the government e-portal.
Okay.
We're requiring and encouraging persons to access the e-portal prior to 2016 mm-hmm. so that when we do announce the launch date, they're ready.
Okay.
There are other issues. Well, the pay portal for this new initiative is by credit card.
Okay.
So we're encouraging persons to make sure that they are ready as far as credit card is concerned. Make mm-hmm. sure the credit cards are there available. They have accessed the e-portal. Mm-hmm. They have gotten, we found that a lot of persons, when they've accessed the government e-portal, there are issues with their NIB numbers and their names.
Okay.
So it has been challenging for them. So we want them to make sure that they have regulated have gotten their NIB numbers consistent with their names. So mm-hmm. when they do access the government e-portal, everything is on point, and the whole registration process is not difficult.
Okay, so what is the government e-portal? What is the exact link for that?
The government e-portal is the www.bahamas.gov.bs.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and what would they search in order to get to your page?
They would have to, once they get, well, first of all, the government e-portal is mm-hmm. just the gateway to the Registrar General's page, so okay. you'll have to get into that first.
Okay.
When you get into that, then you'll have to look for Registrar General's section. Mm-hmm. There, most departments have a section on the government web page, mm-hmm. so just look for RGD, mm-hmm. and then you can access to that.
Okay. So you can start doing that now then. Mm-hmm. You can go on and you can look to see that you yes. make sure that you have those things in place. Right. Now for the end users, people who've tested the system, what is it like using the system? Do you think that it's user-friendly, and do they need some sort of expert in IT in order to do it, or should they be fine in doing it on their own?
Yeah, I think the Registrar General has done an excellent job of making sure that the portal is very user-friendly, it's mm-hmm. very simple. The interface makes sense for people who typically incorporate companies now. Mm-hmm. It's just a question of familiarizing yourself mm-hmm. with the portal, and I think that will happen through training. Mm-hmm. They've already had a first training day, and I'm sure there will be more to come.
Okay.
And so I think you know, both from the business user and also individual users, I think they'll both find it a very pleasant experience.
All right.
And even if they have problems accessing the government portal, mm-hmm. they can call my office okay. or they can call the Department of Information Technology, who mm-hmm. have been very helpful in ensuring that persons get onto the government portal.
Okay.
And I think this is a good opportunity to commend the Registrar General's Department. I had the opportunity to participate in one of their training sessions, but they're really engaging the private sector for mm-hmm. feedback mm-hmm. to ensure that it is a smooth experience for end users. So they're open to feedback, mm-hmm. and that's been a good experience.
All right, awesome. Yeah. And so I just want to get those numbers again, because I'm sure people are going to want to know more. I'm hoping that we'll be hearing more about it in the media, and I'm sure that we will. But how can people reach you just to get a bit more information if they need to?
Okay, they can reach the Registrar General's Department at 397. Okay. 397, when you don't call yourself often.
I call myself either, so it happens to me all the time. So I'll tell you this much. You can find the information if you go to that government portal. I've used the portal before,
okay.
and I do know that there's a contact listing there for each of these organizations.
There is.
So you can definitely find it there. And ladies, we want to thank you so much for being with us this morning. Aliyah is going to be your last time on with us as a senior person over there at the Financial Services Board. So yes. congratulations
thank
to you, and congratulations to you for coming
thank
in.
You,
we look forward to hearing more wonderful things from you. I'm excited about this process, Ms. Magor.
I'm very excited.
All right. You've been watching Bahamas at Sunrise, and we're going to be right back.
Sunday, December 6th, join the cast of Tamara Moncur's Christmas on Sapodilla Street.
Yes. What? gamblers. But the people on top of the other street say they wicked. And they
No one said anything to me about you.
What?
Showtime is at 5 p.m. at the National Center for the Performing Arts on Shirley Street. Tickets can be purchased at the Lil Mustard Seed Cafe, Mount Royal Avenue.
Boy, people here on Zapadilla Street, really strange. But thank God I only visited before summer I ever rub off on you.
Tickets are $15 adults, $10 for kids.
When you think of Andros, think of nature at its best.
When you think of Andros, think of colorful places.
When you think of Andros, think of beautiful people taking care of each other and our guests.
Think Andros.
Think bone fishing. Think Andros. Think diving.
Think Andros. Think people to people.
Welcome back to Bahamas at Sunrise. As we all know, e-commerce is changing the way we do business, and in the Bahamas, it is no exception. We have an app. It's called Mobile Assist, and what it's designed to do is to assist you on your shopping expeditions, and I'm going to let our good friends Donovan Moxie and Philip Simon tell us all about it. Gentlemen, welcome to Bahamas at Sunrise. This Mobile Assist is very exciting stuff. This is sort of e-commerce in the Bahamas. I'm hearing coupons, I'm hearing direct images, messages coming up on your cell phone. I'm hearing all the things that gets the average shopper excited. So let's begin it. The first beginning, as they say in Long Island. What is Mobile Assist?
Thank you very much, and I appreciate you having us, Romy. Mobile Assist is a new mobile app that allows businesses and organizations to better communicate to their customers.
Okay.
Within the app itself, we have over 60 different categories that businesses fit into.
Okay.
And then businesses can essentially have what we call an app page created that allows them to send out coupons, notifications, conduct mobile commerce, link to all of their Facebook and social media sites, if you will. And so as an end user, you now have a free app that gives you access to every single communication and functional channel that a organization may offer to your business.
So going through the processes, we would download the app to our smartphone.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And then what happens now?
You would download the app to your smartphone. You would then go into the app and you would find those businesses and organizations that you like or want to receive notifications from. You then favorite them. And then once you've done that, if an organization wants to send out a coupon or a notification to you, that comes directly to your phone. So there's no need to worry about clipping coupons anymore. There's no need to worry about missing important messages from a particular company, whether it's a school or an organization or a business. All of that now sits within your Mobile Assist app. And we picked the name Mobile Assist, it's short for Mobile Assistant, which means you have now an assistant on a phone that gives you one-click access to a number of different organizations, if you will, that you want to connect to.
It sounds really interesting. Let's just say I was going to shop at Kelly's, mm-hmm. and I have this Mobile Assist on my phone. Mm-hmm. As a part of my experience, what can I anticipate after?
Well, it depends on what Kelly is offering. Certainly, you know, the functionality that Donovan is talking about. Kelly's, for example, would want to provide you with information. They might want to provide you with specials, and that you can certainly purchase right then and there. They can push information out to you. So whether it's Kelly's, whether it's SuperValu, whether it's KFC, you might
Bamboo
be exactly.
<you.
laughs> And in fact, you might be passing. And in fact, you know, we do the geofencing in such a way that you might be passing that particular location, and the information is pushed out to you.
You might
want to turn back around and see what's going on.
Well, what's interesting is you don't have to read the newspaper then to know what's going on. As soon as you enter the store, from what I'm hearing, as soon as you enter the store, all of the good information is coming up live on your phone.
Absolutely.
That's correct, yeah.
It's interesting stuff. Now, in association with this sort of release, you have a scratch and win program, so I guess to bring awareness.
Yes, definitely. Yeah, we're interested in the app with the scratch and win promotion. The app is going to be made available for download this Friday from the Google Play Store, and soon to come would be the iOS or the Apple Store. What Scratch and Win essentially allows you to do, once you opt into the campaign, you will get a series of trivia questions like you normally do. Mm-hmm. Once you answer those questions, if you answer it correctly, you get a coupon that's worth at least 5 to 10 times what you just paid to enter the Scratch and Win promotion. And we're charging 50 cents per entry plus VAT. And so now, as a user, yeah, you've spent that initial 50 cents, but what that also does is that enters you into a raffle where you can share in $15,000 in cash and prizes. So in addition to the coupon that you get that's very valuable, we're launching the app with our partners at Harbor Bay. So quite a number of the shores at Harbor Bay are participating with us, and they're giving us exclusive coupons that you would get as an end user when you play the Scratch & Win promotion.
And you say on Friday, it's going to be available?
Yes, Friday it'll be available entirely through the Bahamas for download. We're actually having a launch event at Green Parrot, East Bay. And so we're very excited about it, and we're asking everybody to come out and essentially be a part of the app.
All right. So let me ask Philip this question then. We're launching Mobile Assist. Mm-hmm. It's going to revolutionize the way people shop in the Bahamas. I can see something big happening right here, right, in terms of getting the information to you. Mm-hmm. What would you say to those persons who are maybe a little bit skeptical, saying to themselves, well, I'm not sure if I want to put this on my phone?
Why not? I mean, why not? I mean, you're already using your phone every day for all different types of things. Whenever you pass anybody on the streets or anybody, even at work, the phone is literally right next to you. So here it is now. You have something called the mobile assistant. And you have a directory at your fingertips. You'll be able to contact. It's not just for stores. It's not just for commercial use. The way that we are expanding this particular application, not just here in the Bahamas, but throughout the Caribbean, is that we are bringing all of us together. So whether it's the private sector, whether it's government entities, whether it's NGOs, they will all have this particular platform to utilize.
That's interesting. So even in terms of government offices, and I'm just thinking forms and deadlines for applying, et cetera, et cetera. Mm-hmm. And if you're just in the vicinity, it pushes onto your phone. How can people find out more information about it? This is a limited interview.
Yes.
We're trying to get that curiosity going.
Yeah. Great question. We have a website called mymobileassist.com. So they can go to mymobileassist.com, find out about the app, find out about the promotion. And if you're a business or an organization, once you get there, click on app page or app listing, and it'll tell you just how you can be involved in the app, if you will.
I got to talk to the producer here at Bahamas at Sunrise, man.
Be a great app at Bahamas at Sunrise.
We got to be on the app, man.
And you've got a tremendous following, so you encourage persons to participate.
Exactly. And one of the things you can do is, the day before the show, you can just send a notification, let everybody know who's going to be on the show. It comes right to their phone.
Man, it's excellent stuff. Congratulations on the product. We look forward to you coming here and taking us through a live demonstration, on TV. It's going to be exciting stuff. Donovan Moxie, Philip Simon, thank you so much for being on Bahamas at Sunrise. Congratulations on the app, Mobile Assist, and of course, only good things happen to you when you come to Bahamas at Sunrise.
<That's true. laughs>
You put the icing on the cake. Yeah. You're watching Bahamas at Sunrise. We'll be back after this.
Mr. Turner is in a rush for a chance he doesn't want to miss. With over 14 destinations to choose from, you can see why he's so eager to experience the world-class staff and service. Sky Bahamas, flying into more cities in the Bahamas than any other airline in the world. When it comes to the skies of the Bahamas, we simply do them better.
When I fly with Sky.
Sky Bahamas.
Renewing pride in our people. Lending social assistance to families trying to make a change.
The government is implementing CCT, the Conditional Cash Transfer Program, which is proving successful in our region. CCT is a new exciting form of social assistance to help Bahamians break free of the poverty cycle with dignity. CCT provides a cash benefit and many more, with an emphasis on improving the health and education of our families. CCT has the advantage of transparency, improved targeting, automation, better monitoring, better processing, improved service, improving client dignity. Call the Social Safety Net hotline at 397-8628. The Department of Social Services. Together, we rise.
Inspiring your rise, sustaining your rise, empowering you to rise.
And now, your hosts, Romuald Ferreira and Anastasia Palacios. Welcome back to Bahamas at Sunrise at the halfway point. been an exciting show thus far. That mobile assist, mm-hmm. I mean, that's good stuff.
That is really good stuff. I'm so excited to see the new technology coming to the Bahamas. We've got mobile assist that's great for businesses to get signed up for, great for consumers to use to find businesses with sure. ease and to get special discounts, which we know we need in this market. You're still talking about the $5 eggs. And then I'm really excited about the
$5.69.
I'm really excited about the government e-service, because here's the thing. The Registrar sure. General was letting me know off air that in addition to what we talked about with businesses being incorporated, they're going totally e-service. So if you get a maritime marriage, you're getting married abroad, this doesn't apply to you or me, but for the people out there, if you're getting married abroad, you want to do what you need to do in terms of paperwork, you can do that online. You can upload deeds online, and sure. even intellectual property now nice. You can apply for online, and then they'll send it back to you. So this is going to be really exciting stuff in 2016, and I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, it's very exciting stuff. This is an exciting time to be in the Bahamas, all things considered. We're glad you tuned in to Bahamas at Sunrise. Of course, it's going to be a fantastic day for you, because only good things happen when you tune into Bahamas at Sunrise. And the second half of our show promises to be equally as exciting as the first.
Yeah, man. We are looking forward to finding out more about Christmas on Sapodilla Street. Christmas is just a few days away, and we've got an awesome cast and crew in studio with us to tell you what Christmas on Sapodilla Street is all about.
I'm still trying to figure out what a sapodilla is. I wonder if they mean Naysbury or Dilly.
They mean Dilly. All right, Christmas on Dilly Street.
My Jamaican friends will know what Naysbury is all about. And in addition to all of that, we have the Rotary Club is hosting a jazz event, and it's a Christmas jazz event for an excellent cause. You want to stay tuned to find out the details.
So we've got all of that coming up for you, and a little bit of jazz with that jazz section. But first, let's turn it over to the Dapper Don himself, as my co-host would say, Godfrey Burnside.
Weather at Sunrise, brought to you by Bahamas First. First in insurance, today, tomorrow.
Thank you, Stan. Good morning, Bahamas. Your second look at weather sunrise. It's the final day of the 2015 tropical cyclone season. The trop is quiet, and so you don't have anything to worry about for the remainder of the year until June 1st, 2016. In yesterday, Lake Louise, you can actually see high pressure dominated weather in northwest Bahamas. Very light, little clouds around, one to passing showers by afternoon. But in the central and southeast, there's a trough that's producing cloudy skies with showers and possible thunderstorms over that area today, and that'll be around for the next couple of days. In your marine forecast, those winds today northeast to east at 10 to 15 knots, sea 2 to 4 feet. Pretty advising boaters and swimmers to still look out for those northeasty swells up to about 6 to 8 feet during the daytime. On Tuesday, those winds become easterly at 10 to 15 knots, sea 2 to 4 feet. And then on Wednesday, those winds east to southeast at 15 knots, sea 3 to 5 feet over the northwest and central Bahamas, easterly at 15 knots, sea 3 to 5 feet over the southeastern islands. Yeah, tides. You can expect a high tide at 10:52 this morning. Next low tide will be at 5:24 this evening, high gain to 9:11:23. Sunset at 5:20 this evening, rises tomorrow morning at 6:38, UV index 7, your water temperature 78 degrees Fahrenheit, and your moon phase now moving towards the last quarter. And your extended look, partly sunny skies through Wednesday, Thursday in the northwest Bahamas. Those cloudy skies will continue into Wednesday, Thursday across the central southeast Bahamas. And your next cold front is expected to be here sometime on Friday, and that will cause some increasing cloudiness for the weekend. Temperature daytime will be in the low to mid 80s at daytime and the low 70s at nighttime. That was the Robin Fan look at weather sunrise. I'm Godfrey Burnside. Back to you, Star.
Thanks, Godfrey. Now, I know around this time you are popping popcorn, drinking some hot chocolate, watching all of those Hallmark shows. Some of you are watching reruns of Miracle on 34th Street. Now, let me tell you, let's cut all of that. We want to do this bohemian style. So I want you to get off of Miracle on 34th Street. We're heading down to Sapodilla Street to find out about Christmas on Sapodilla Street, an exciting new play that's coming to you. And I'm excited today because I'm interviewing the directors, producers, writers, and this crew of cast members from Sapodilla Street. Good morning and welcome to Bahamas at Sunrise.
Good morning and thank you for having us.
Now, this is Mr. and Ms. Monka, right?
Yes.
A husband and wife team. I love the dynamics here. And so I want to find out from you, what is Christmas on Sapodilla Street?
Before we start, I just want to say a shout out to Kingsway Boys, who just won a championship on Saturday night.
Oh, really?
Hey, boys.
Coach. Mr. Monk, he's a coach at Kingsway. Yeah. You got that.
So South Adelaide Street is a Bahamian community coming together, experiencing so much different drama and issues. Mm-hmm. But because of the Christmas season and really what Christmas is about, mm-hmm. we find it in our hearts to come together and love and share and all the good things that Christmas brings.
Okay.
But all the drama in between.
I'm sure, right? Yes. It sounds like a regular Christmas family dinner.
Exactly,
and
right.
Okay, so now what can the audience expect in terms of the storyline? We're talking about that drama, but what are some of the key issues that we will see coming out in the play?
Well, definitely we're going to have some love and hate relationships.
Oh, gee.
We're going to have some gossiping. We're going to have some gambling.
Okay.
And some drinking.
We got some people who are going to kind of send you to hell.
Okay.
But thank mm-hmm. God for the pastor mm-hmm. who's going to pray you right back into heaven.
Amen. I think we are not there for the pastor.
Yes.
Okay.
And pastor now, always looking for concert.
Yeah, so.
What has been the most exciting part of about working on this script and bringing it to life for you?
The cast.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, trying to learn how to say our lines without bursting into laughter. Because every day somebody brings up something new.
Okay. Now, there are a lot of young Bahamians who are interested in getting into acting, who want to find a release, and I know that drama can do that for you. If they wanted to be a part of your group, how would they go about doing that?
First of all, they got to come watch the show.
Okay, they got to come watch the show.
Exactly, uh-huh. And we'll have a sign-up sheet for anybody who's interested in drama, and that's also singing, because we do have a lot of singers in the show.
Yes. So, look. So that means, I'm assuming then, that means we got some singing happening in the show.
Oh, yeah.
So forget Tyler Perry and Medea. We got some Bahamian stuff out
there. We got it right here on Sapodilla Street.
All right. See? So now I want to find out the dates of the event and where I can buy those tickets.
Okay. So the date is next week Sunday, which mm-hmm. is December 6th mm-hmm. at 5 p.m. at the National Center for Performing Arts. Mm-hmm. And tickets can be found at Little Mustard Seed on Mount Royal
Avenue.
Okay.
Just a few doors away from the Paint Place. Mm-hmm. And Teacher's Mart.
Okay.
Yeah. And of course, if by chance you aren't able to make it, mm-hmm. you could also pay at the door.
Okay.
Same price, $15 are the tickets for adults, $10 for children. Mm-hmm. It's a family show. Mm-hmm. Everyone is invited.
Family show, everyone's invited. $15 for tickets. Are you on Facebook? How could we get in contact with you if they need to ask questions or they want some more
Facebook
information?
We have a Facebook page. Mm-hmm. It's called After Dark Productions. You would even be able to see clips of our previous shows.
Okay,
yes,
okay.
So we
could get a taste of what was in the past.
Oh, yes.
We could focus on what's coming in the future,
yes.
And we can learn more about you. Now, this one must have taken a lot of work. I know a lot of times Bahamians don't appreciate the value of the hard work that goes into these plays. Tell us about the process of getting it to this point.
Wow. The process was very, very hard, very difficult, because you have the marketing, you have casting, trying to get the right people for the right parts, you have rehearsals, you have selling tickets, mm-hmm. finding venues for practice, mm-hmm. musicians, the whole nine yards, shooting commercials.
Mm-hmm.
So even though the process,
lights and sound.
Lights and sound, so everybody's a part of this, and backup singers and all of that.
Oh, yeah.
But
no,
nevertheless, full production. Uh-huh. We put everything in this. You know, we from Sapodilla Street.
All right. So Sapodilla Street will be happening on that Sunday, December 6th.
Yes.
Tickets are $15.
Yes.
And this entire cast that is with me in studio.
Yes.
We're going to see them on the stage.
Oh, yes. In all of their splendor. We actually have three absent. It's about 13 of us in total.
Mm-hmm.
So come and enjoy.
Come and laugh.
All right?
And we're covering those major issues. We're covering gambling. We're covering gossip, which is what... And I'm hoping, and I know that from this, people will get the message that... Thank God for Jesus,
Jesus. Yeah, and also community. You know, I grew up in the 1970s, mm-hmm. 80s, where family and community is kind of were hand in hand.
Mm-hmm.
And so I think we're kind of bringing that back.
Okay.
Where your neighbor is not only your neighbor, but also your friend, like your family member. So that's how we live on Sapodilla
Street. So are you all excited about Sapodilla Street?
Yes. Yes.
And I should come and see this play.
Yes. Oh, yes.
You've heard it from them themselves, the stars of Sapodilla Street. I will be there with them on December 6th. At what time? What time we get started?
At 5 p.m.
I can't get 5 p.m.
Yes.
$15 tickets for adults, $10 tickets for children. Congratulations on bringing the vision
sheep
to life.
Sheep.
Thank you.
Sheep, go. That's us.
Yeah.
And we are now going to commercial. Let me see if I can get some mutton sauce while they're talking about sheep, sheep, and go, go.
Yeah.
We'll be right back.
There's
no place like Exuma.
With our striking, beautiful waters.
And loyalist tombs.
And even warmer hearts.
And there are no people like the people of Exuma.
We are the people.
We are the people.
We are the people of People to People, Exuma!
Volunteer as a People to People ambassador today.
Are you behind on your real property tax? The Department of Inland Revenue is offering shelter. From now until December 2015, the DIR is extending a waiver of the property tax surcharge to registered owners of residential properties in one of two ways. One, set up a standing order or salary deduction arrangement to pay your property tax arrears and the current tax. Or two, pay your outstanding tax bill in full. To learn more, call the Department of Inland Revenue at 242-225-7280 or email us at taxinquiries@bahamas.gov.bs.
One thing, two things, little thing, all things, things that are small, things that are grand, things that fit just right, and in the palm of your hand. Fox Hill Nursery, a large selection of garden supplies. If you can see it in your mind, you can find it at Fox Hill Nursery.
No place like Exuma.
With our striking, beautiful waters.
And loyalist tombs.
And even warmer hearts.
And there are no people like the people of Exuma.
We are the people.
We are the people.
We are the people of People to People, Exuma.
Volunteer as a People to People ambassador today.
Are you behind on your real property tax? The Department of Inland Revenue is offering shelter. From now until December 2015, the DIR is extending a waiver of the property tax surcharge to registered owners of residential properties in one of two ways. One, set up a standing order or salary deduction arrangement to pay your property tax arrears and the current tax. Or two, pay your outstanding tax bill in full. To learn more, call the Department of Inland Revenue at 242-225-7280 or email us at taxinquiries@bahamas.gov.bs.
Welcome back to Bahamas at Sunrise. This is the segment you've all been waiting for. It's the Jingle Bell Jazz segment presented by Sunrise Rotary Club. And we certainly are so pleased to have our very three special guests. It takes three to bring this message.
Right.
Madam President Alana McCartney, Dr. Sophia Roll, and of course, Chris Justillian. None of them are strangers to you, with maybe the exception of Madam President. So to all of you, welcome to Bahamas at Sunrise. Now, let's talk a little bit about the club, though, and let's find out the good work of Rotary Sunrise.
Well, firstly, NASA Sunrise meets at the Hilton Hotel at 7 a.m. on Thursday mornings, for starters.
Okay.
Our focus has been youth, development, and elderly. Upkeep.
That 7 a.m. time sounds a lot.
You got stuck on that.
Bahamas at Sunrise.
Yeah.
So congratulations,
yes,
you and
you.
I. But obviously, this is an important fundraiser for the club.
Yeah, it
because
is.
Because you have your programs going on. And
yes.
You need funds.
We need funds to execute on our programs.
All right. Let's go ahead.
This is our annual jazz event. We've had it for the last several years on this first weekend of December.
Okay.
Chris Justillian is not new to us, and we're very excited about this weekend's event.
Why is that?
Because this, for the first time this year, we're partnering with the
Monuments Antiquities Corporation, as well as the College of the Bahamas Concert Band.
Okay.
And we are intending on having a fantastic event on Friday evening. We're in the lower grounds of the historic Centerville. That is the official name of the Centerville, the old Ministry of Education's building.
Okay,
we say Collins House. We know it as Collins House, but the official name is Centerville.
Okay.
And so
the lower grounds too.
The lower grounds. It's a beautiful venue.
Yeah.
And we're going to have a beautiful evening of live entertainment by Ambassa as well as the College of the Bahamas' band. And all of the proceeds for this event goes to Hurricane Joaquin, as well as we're going to be donating to the college's concert band or the music department. And so we're really encouraging the public to come out and support this event. It's a mere $50, and that is going to go a very, very long way. We don't keep any of the funds raised in Rotary. All of the funds raised in Rotary goes back into the community, mm-hmm. and we are one of the only service clubs that does that. At the end of the fiscal year, all money is spent, and so we are encouraging people to assist us in our venture this Friday. It's going to be a wonderful event. Chris, I don't know if you want to speak to your involvement with us this year, because this is, again, a first time we are partnering with the college.
Well, it's really a pleasure to be a part of this project. The College of the Bahamas Band, we usually have an annual Christmas concert. And when we heard about this event, we sought out to partner with Rotary so we can get more exposure for our students. We have a wonderful concert band. We have students that are doing small ensemble work. They're going to start the evening off with a wonderful selection of Christmas music. And then Ambassa's going to be mm-hmm. taking it over later on with some dance music and some jazz and a mix of other things. We also have another small combo at the College of the Bahamas. Sean Penniman and his friends, they're going to be doing some jazz and some Bahamian music and some other things as well.
Yeah.
So you're in for a wonderful evening of music and Christmas jollies.
Christmas jollies. All right, yes. hand the mic to Madam President. You know, we got a whole lot hostage. I think this is your first time. Your nuptial flight always has to
it
be
is.
A good flight. Now, Dr. Roll mentioned about the lovely grounds, but the grounds are only lovely and beautiful because of the people.
Exactly.
Who are going to be there to adorn
exactly.
those grounds and I give it its luster. So how can we get these tickets and what's included with these tickets?
We have a couple of options. You have general admission, $50.
Mm-hmm.
We have VIP tables. We're selling at $1,000, 10 persons per table.
Okay.
VIP comes with dinner, wine, and gifts. General admission comes with hors d'oeuvres.
Okay.
Drinks are available.
I gotcha.
It's going to be fun for both sets of people because we intend to make it that way.
Yeah, I'm sure, because all you got to do when someone gets up from the table is you mosey on in and sit down. Where can we get the tickets from, though?
Tickets are available at Woodside Insurance Company on Collins up Madera Street.
Okay.
As well as Rotarians from Nassau Sunrise.
All right.
Any one of us can sell you tickets.
Yeah, so
but definitely Woodside Insurance on Collins Avenue.
All right. And the event is coming up this weekend.
This week, Friday, at Collins House, Lower Grounds, right there on Collins Avenue and Shirley Street. Big banner on the gate. Can't miss it.
Can't miss it. All right.
Can't miss it.
Well, I'll allow Dr. Rowe mercifully to give us a last word, any kind of recap, and then we're going to turn things over to Chris so we can have a little sample, a little taste of what's to come.
Because I have to play to them.
I just want to.
I gotcha.
I really want to encourage the public at large, but particularly the College of the Bahamas' grouping, the alumni from the college. We want to support the College of the Bahamas, and this is our way of supporting the College of the Bahamas as well as Hurricane Joaquin. A lot has been done for Hurricane Joaquin, so. In addition to that, we want to support the college, but we want the college community to support the college as well. And so we're really asking for their support and the public support.
All right, I'm sure you'll get it. Only good things happen when you come on Bahamas at Sunrise. Now, Chris, I know you're going to perform something for us, for these ladies. And our wider audience out there, because they're equally as important. So I'm going to ask our studio assistant to press the space bar.
Yeah.
And at that point, we're going to turn things over to your musical talents, which I'm sure are bound to impress us all.
Well, while he attends to the music, you said $50. You said it's Rotary Sunrise. It's going to be a fantastic event.
You got food, you got hors d'oeuvres, you got wine, you got the College of the Bahamas, you got Ambassa, and you got you.
And you got us. And you got us. Pregnant and accounted for. Fun.
All right.
Good to see you.
Sounds like I'm going to be right there.
All right.
Hungry and sober. Well, that sounds fantastic. Sounds like the exciting event. Yeah. Remind our viewers, date, time, place, and say our final, as we say our final goodbyes.
Friday, December 4th, beginning at 6:30. We have a happy hour at 6:30, but the event starts at 7. Mm-hmm. We'd really like to thank Dr. Keith Tinker, as well as Mrs. Dorset at the Monuments and Antiquities Corporation for allowing us to use the grounds. We really want to thank them for that.
All right, and so if you thank them, that means we thank you here. Big thank you, and good morning to all the staff at Antiquities and Monuments. Amen. Congratulations on your event. It's going to be fantastic. You're on Bahamas at Sunrise. Good things will flow. Starts this Friday. So the action is on. We roll right
we're
into the
we're the first event for the Christmas season, so we want to be there.
And I've been to it before, Romy, and it really is quite good.
Yes,
so you really want to check it out.
Your father-in-law said he's going to be there.
Y'all have him singing? You know, we like to grab the mic, but he don't sing jazz this time, so.
Well, you never know.
Oh, I know. Let's stick with Chris. Let's stick with Chris and the music.
Please keep the mic away from him. Anyway, have a safe week. See you guys on Friday, though.
Yes.
Congratulations to Rotary Sunrise Rotary Club. Still looking for our invitation to come to one of those meetings, but I'm going to let Anna stop here.
Every Thursday morning, 7 a.m. at the Hilton Hotel.
Oh, man, it's going to be great.